Theater at the Boston Conservatory. Please take a moment to turn off all electronic devices. We would like to remind you that there is no photography or recording of any kind allowed. We also ask that you take a moment to locate the nearest exit. They are located to the left of the stage, in the rear of the theater, and the door through which you entered. In the event of an emergency, please calmly exit and move away from the building. This world premiere performance of Gallo by Ken Ueno, directed by Sarah Meyers, is brought to you in part through the generosity of our season sponsors, Timothy and Jane Gillette, and our premier cheerio sponsor, Peter Wender. Tonight's performance is being streamed live online. We want to thank our online viewers as well as to the Boston Conservatory Marketing and Audiovisual Department for making this possible. Thank you and enjoy the performance.
the beach. Is an existential space. Family vacations, happy moments in the sun, the devastation of tsunamis, tragic markers of epic transformation, death of an era, all played out on the ever-changing, ever-same. Says that Werner von Braun said, nature does not know extinction. All it knows is transformation. There are spaces in which nature and a trace of human endeavor. It was ostensibly a village, but it tells us about the whole structure, the economy of the Roman Empire. Prehistoric terraced hills on the island. Nature transforms all of human enterprises into transformation. Landscape transforms man as much as wind transforms the landscape. consumed by that which we consume. And the ontological loop.
Thank you.
music, each competing for a layer of your attention.
Thank you. Part Thank you. I
Along the way, we saw bee eaters. We heard them first, chirps inseparable from the wind, crowns glorious, colorful wings translucent. Such delicate, fragile beauty. It was only later, when we looked them up online, that we found out that they were bee eaters. Strange birds. They catch bees mid-flight and smack them against rocks to de-sting them. In a sense, they were like her. Corners full of dead bees. These beautiful birds have migrated from Africa, and they will destroy this lush greenery. Whole colonies of bee eaters dig nests into the sides of ditches, the banks of our trail were pockmarked by their burrows, tiny box seats for the opera at the end of the world. When we got to the castle, she pulled me up to the upper floor, through the hole where a staircase used to be. We glided, imagining the opulent dance of the aristocrats who had vista looked out across the whole valley. And at that moment, she completed the landscape. Like an inevitable lost piece in a puzzle. So were we. And it felt like all of it made sense. At that moment, it felt like all of human history led to that moment. The Viscount or Duke, whose ruined castle we were claiming as our stage. The bee eater, the dogs who followed us up to the top of the trail, our friends down in their apartments spread down the hill, Umberto, Rome, and further down that hill to our normal lives at home. Our students, our families, our lovers, our rents and credit card statements, our broken mufflers, and gluten-free pizza. She gave me a kite to give my girlfriend. I wanted like a red balloon in a French movie. Back down in town, I was the DJ for our karaoke parties, curating the words for our friends to sing. At the end of history, sounds and words are decoupled. All we do now is exchange word game volleys online. She is my figment now, walking beside me. A coward. David Attenborough says that the human vocal mechanism is capable of making many more sounds than are necessary for language. He says this is evidence that we sang before we spoke. You breathe in, you breathe out, you breathe in, you breathe out, you breathe in. Never, never, never wonder why. Although your world wonders me with your majestic and superior cackling hen, your people I do not understand.